Once again, it's time to play We Love Us, radio's topmost quiz for proper pop stars. And joining us all this week are the massed ranks of Manson. And we're starting off today with lead singer Paul. Paul!
Morning.
How are you?
Good, how are you, mate?
Yeah, not bad at all. Where are you?
And in Edinburgh.
Oh, right. Was you playing there last night?
Yeah, at the venue.
How was that, then?
It was good.
And where are you playing tonight?
Newcastle.
Oh, right, yeah. Things are going all right for you, aren't you? I think that LP of yours is going to do quite well, you know.
Do you think so, yeah?
I think it could do quite well in the charts. So keep an eye on that.
I think so, if you say, then.
Yeah, right. And are you playing in Manchester on Thursday?
We are, yeah.
Because we're coming.
Good.
So that's a tonic, eh?
Good, yeah.
At least there'll be two of us there. Right, you sound a bit groggy. Is he out on the sauce?
Maybe.
All right.
No,
then.
But I was singing really loud.
All right.
I've lost my voice and we've only played two gigs.
Oh, blimey, heck is like. Right, you've lost some hair as well, haven't you? I mean, you've had a serious sort of... you've kind of gone for a bit of a smarter image now, haven't you?
I have, yeah. I've had it cut again, though, since that.
Have you?
Yeah, just looks like Johnny Rotten now.
Oh, does it?
All sticking out everywhere.
I like that big pudding basin you used to have. It was...
It was a good one.
Anyway, never mind, right.
It's hard to look after, though.
I should think so, yeah. I should think so. I wouldn't know, really. Right, are you ready to play this?
I am, I'm ready.
Who's the band expert on the band? Would you say you are... you fancy your chances?
I don't know. I don't think anyone's an expert, really, but I'll give it a go.
All right, here we go, then. Who arranged the strings on tracks Dark Mavis and The Chad Who Loved Me? On your LP, Stefan.
And his second name begins with a G.
It does, yeah.
But I don't know any more than that.
That'll do, won't it?
Give him that. Yay!
Stefan Girardet.
That's it, yeah.
That's what it is, right, okay. What book did Chad read from on our old Graveyard Shift evening programme?
The Holy Blood and the Holy Grail.
Is absolutely right, okay. What is the catalogue number of your new album? The UK catalogue number.
What?
Don't know.
UK CD.
CD's right.
Was it?
Yeah.
Go on, give us half of that.
Can't give you half of that. I'll tell you what, it's CD PCS, and then there's four numbers. If you get some of the numbers right, we'll give you half.
007.
There are two sevens in it.
Are there really?
We only said one.
0077.
Seven.
Whey! Half point.
CD PCS 7387.
I can't believe he didn't know that.
What's he got so far? Oh, have you got two and a half?
Yeah.
Two and a half, that's all right, yeah. Who appeared with you on the front cover of The Melody Maker on March
1st, 1997? No Doubt.
Yeah. And a comedian?
Eddie Izzard.
No, it's Mark Lamar.
Ooh. How soon they forget.
I'll give you another half for No Doubt. So that's three out of four. Okay?
Yeah.
All right.
Get half for a bunch of flowers on fire.
No, we're not. Okay.
Don't be cheeky.
Okay, then. According to The Melody Maker, which two members of the band claim that The Carpenters' compact disc collection is among their favourite records?
Well, I've got that.
Yeah.
But I don't know whether it was me.
It was you, your was one.
Yeah, and, was it, Stove?
No! It was Chad!
Oh, no, that stove's into ABBA.
Oh, is it right? Well,
yeah, it's got mixed up.
There you go. So, well, we'll give you half a point for yourself.
Yeah.
We'll take it off. So that's 3.5 out of 5.
Is that good?
Well, it depends what the rest of them are like. If the rest of your band are a load of thickgets who don't know anything about the band, then it's very good.
Great, well, I've won already, then.
If they're all brilliant, but anyway, you know, we'll see how we go in the rest of the week, eh?
Fantastic.
All right, Paul, we'll see you on Thursday at Manchester.
See you later, mate.
All right, thanks very much for playing We Love Us. That's Paul out of Manson. And the top quality competitions just keep on coming. Once again, it's time to play We Love Us with a proper pop star from a proper pop group. And all this week it is Manson, and somewhere bleary-eyed on the line should be Dominic Chad. Are you there?
I am.
Oh, very bleary-eyed.
Wakey!
Where are you? Not sure.
Christ, you got me there. I'm in Newcastle, right.
Right, okay then.
We played there last night.
And how was that, alright?
Yeah, it was great.
And did you have a bit of a bender afterwards?
No.
No, right. Okay.
Did you have a drink?
Oh, pathetic. What a sad shot. Right, okay then. Now then, Paul got 3.5 yesterday.
Really?
No doubt you heard it, because you were all up, gathered round the radio, weren't you?
Absolutely.
And you've drawn the short straw today. All right, so...
Paul's in here as well, so he's had it twice now.
You what?
Paul's in here now. So
oh, is he?
He's been right. Working up.
He's keen. Fair enough, right. Are you still wearing many frocks, or are you going for more for pants these days?
More for pants.
Good call.
Okay, right. Are you ready?
I am.
And remember, there's a foot spa on this.
Oh, right.
You know, now that's made...
That hadn't been explained to me.
Exactly.
He's woken up now,
hasn't he? Woken up now. Hey, yeah, mention a foot spa.
Now everything's painting on a completely different light.
Right, okay, good. Here we go. Where will you be playing on Monday the 17th of March?
Bristol.
Yes!
Was
that a guess?
It was.
Good heavens, right, well, it is right.
It was a pretty phenomenal guess, wasn't it?
It was, in as much as it was right. Bristol University. What label was Take It Easy Chicken originally released on?
Sci-Fi Hi-Fi.
Is the right answer. It's going very well for Dominic Tatty. See, like, give them some consumer goods. They're there, aren't they?
Pricked up immediately.
Pricked up. What's the B-side? Hang on, I don't understand this. Hang on, we'll do this one. What was your third release on the Parlophone label?
Manson EP3.
And what's the main track on that?
Supervic.
Indeed, so. What's on the other side of Flowerella?
Skin Up, Pin Up.
Yes!
Whoa! Well done, you.
Yeah, you're beating Paul already. You could make a clean sweep of this.
I could do.
Here we go. Let's find a really, really hard one.
Make a clean pair of feet with it as well.
Okay. What is the email address of your fan club?
At a guess, www.co.uk/Manson.
Actually, you're very close to it. I think you said all the bits, but you put too many of them in the wrong order. So, just to keep the competition alive, I am not going to give it you.
Oh.
And the actual answer is www.manson.co.uk. And you had all the bits
in
there.
You're a hard man.
Well, I'm just keeping it alive till the end of the week, you know. I'll give you 4, but you've beaten Paul anyway. It's always good for the lead guitarist to beat the lead singer, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, then, fair enough. All right, are you playing tonight? Are you playing tonight, mate?
We are.
Where's
Middlesbrough.
Tonight? Middlesbrough, okay.
Yeah. Are we going to see you on Thursday?
Oh, indeed you are. Indeed you are. I mean, in fact, we could present the foot spa, couldn't we? Because unless there's a tie break.
Ooh.
We present the foot spa live on stage at Manchester University.
Oh, that'll be sold out now.
Right, it's sold out before because they're a top band live.
Oh, forget about that.
Shut up, Toby Milk Jug. Right, okay then. Thanks a lot, Chad.
Thank you very much.
Enjoy the rest of your day, which is considerably longer than it would otherwise have been now, isn't it? But anyway. All right then, we'll see you soon. Oh, he's gone.
He's gone. He's keen.
He's gone. Desperately keen. He's gone to batter Paul. We play with another member of Manson at the same time tomorrow. This is a wonderful record by a band from Glasgow called Superstar. We love us, radio's top of most quiz for proper pop stars, and all this week you're playing the membership of Manson. And somewhere on the line from a top luxurious hotel, but probably not quite as swanky as the one we put our contestants up, should be bass player Stove. Are you there?
Hello.
Hello, mate, how are you?
I'm good.
Oh, you sound pretty chipper.
I am.
Yeah, very good. Hey, what were you doing last night? Are you playing?
We were in Middlesbrough.
Middlesbrough, and how was that?
It was alright, it was well.
Yeah, okay, right. Are you prepared to reveal your real name?
Sorry?
Are you prepared to reveal your real name? Because obviously you weren't christened Stove, were you?
My real name's James Bond, but it's a bit embarrassing as well.
Oh, right, okay, fair enough. It's not Steve, is it, and you've changed one letter?
No.
Okay.
Carla? Not very original.
No, that wouldn't be original. No, okay. Fair enough. Right, now then, the story so far. Your lead singer Paul got 3.5 on Monday.
Oh, right.
Dominic Chab got 4 yesterday.
He's clever,
so you've got to go some.
Okay.
Are you feeling confident?
I don't know.
All right, fair enough. Well, we'll give it a go.
Okay.
All right, here we go. Which city's main tourist attraction is the mannequin piss?
It's the what?
Oh, sorry, no, that's the Busy Buzzy Bee question. It's at the leftover. Right, here we go. What was the name of the pub that Chad managed in Chester?
The Fat Cat.
The Fat Cat!
Whoa!
No hesitation. One out of that there one. What venue are you playing at in Reading on Wednesday the 12th of March?
The Alley Cat.
The Alley Cat!
Just based around Cat.
I was just wondering that myself, actually. It'll be a, no, it won't be based around Cat, because that would be the Cuddly Cuddly Kitten Quiz, which will be fill another 2 weeks with that.
So. Okay.
What were the two extra tracks that were only available on Stripper Vicar CD 1? Struggling.
The Edge and the Duchess.
He's right!
Whoa!
He's right! Stover's got a perfect three. What date was Wide Open Space released? Let's work backwards. The year?
96.
The month?
November.
Yes.
11th.
Oh!
12th.
Oh! Oh, that's it. So, what should we do? I'll tell you, give it half. It's 18th. It's 18th, but November 96. Should we give you half for that? 3.5,
yeah,
right?
Half.
Okay. So, you can go into, a 4.5 score, which will give you a half a point lead before the drummer comes on tomorrow. I'll tell you what, I'll give you a choice here. Synthesize or model numbers or finishing the lines of the lyrics?
Lyrics.
Lyrics, okay. Finish this line. Do you do any singing?
No.
Do you do what a lot of bass players do and just mouth along without a microphone?
No, definitely.
Right, here we go. Now they sleep in separate bedrooms.
Can you give us the song?
Lemonade Secret Drinker. This music's good, isn't it?
It's good, yeah. It's interlude.
How are we getting anywhere down there?
Now they sleep in separate bedrooms.
Now they sleep in separate bedrooms.
Because I'm a
No, he's not got it.
Oh, what a shame, Scotty. Now they sleep in separate bedrooms since they missed the jackpot on Family Fortunes. Yeah, oh yeah.
I knew that.
I knew that.
He says that in the song.
Well, apparently so. You're never listening, are you, to the singing?
No.
No, all right.
Good call.
Fair enough. Right, are you playing tonight?
No.
Oh, so you got a day off?
Yeah.
Right, okay then. Well, enjoy that, and we'll see you in Manchester tomorrow. And we'll have your drummer on tomorrow, and we'll see if he can beat Chad's score of 4.
Cool.
All right, mate. Thanks very much for playing We Love Us, Stove out of Manson.
We love us, love us.
We're getting better at that, aren't we?
Yeah.
We are getting better at that. Right, it's time to play We Love Us and the grand final climax finale type Doobry Gubbins thing. All the members of Manson have been on this week because today we meet and greet Drumbo, Andy Rathbone. Andy!
Hello!
How are you?
All right, mate.
Very good. You sound the chippermost of the whole bunch.
Do I?
Yeah, you do, yeah.
Oh.
You have a night off last night, so you got an early night, was it?
Just a bit.
Now then, tell me, how many piercings have you got? Because every time I see a picture of you, you seem to have a ring through summit.
I've got two. One in my eye and one that I can't mention.
Right, OK, fair enough then.
My life!
And how are you enjoying being in Manson? Because you're the new boy, aren't you?
I love it.
Yeah.
It says here. I love it.
Right, OK, fair enough. I tell you what, Andy Rathbone, lad.
What?
Cracking drummer or what?
You fantastic drummer.
Cracking drummer.
Saw him on the telly.
Not a joke. No. There's no punchline to this. We just think you're a great drummer.
I love you.
Right, OK. Now, listen, I've got a message from you here.
Have you?
From Di and Pridge and Charlie and Graham.
No!
In Manchester, they say, say hello to them, or better still, get down there today while you're in Manc.
Hello there.
Yeah, all right. And they say they'll get the brews in, turn up to see them, otherwise they'll be forced to start using the photos.
God bless old, though.
They want 4 tickets.
Oh, I've sorted them.
Right, thank you muchly from Diane Pridge there. P.S., please play some Bowie. Should we have Vinyl Vault Bowie tomorrow?
Let's do it.
Let's do that. Right, then.
Right.
So, the Stove and Paul both got 3.5.
Yeah.
And Chad got 4.
Ooh.
So you've got to go some.
Ooh.
Are you ready?
I think so.
Should we have a crack at it?
Oh, dear.
Where did the name Manson originate?
It came from a song by The Verve.
Yeah.
A Man Called Son.
Absolutely.
Yay!
That's 1 out of 1. Which supergroup did co-producer Cliff Norrell also work with?
R.E.M.
Yep. Yeah, he worked on Automatic for the People. Bright and Confident. And here we go. Now, I don't know whether you'll know this one, but you've got a 3-to-1 chance of getting it right anyway.
Right.
A window opened because of the potential we showed, and we jumped through it with both feet. It's a quote from March 1996 from which member of the band?
It's got to be... It's going to be Drake's gig, that one.
Well, do you know what? It was Stove.
No!
Ooh! Wow! Bass player speaks. Shocker.
No way!
Apparently so. Apparently so.
It's a lie. It's a lie.
Right, so you've got to get these two right to equal what Chad got.
Oh.
What lyrics are these, shall I start that again?
Go on, mate.
What lyrics, what song are these lyrics taken from?
Right.
Got there in the end.
We did.
Quality, well, that's my job gone now, like, I'm flipping, you know, ABC, whose testicles are these, daytime quiz shows. She's going to get herself out from her plastic town, she's going to get out her house, going to get down south. Never hear the words, do you, playing the drums at the back there? Never heard the words to any of the songs.
No. It's got to be something like either Dark Babies or Strip of Vicar or Flowerella or something like that.
Or
one of the others.
One of the others you've not said so far.
No.
You don't know, do you?
No.
All right. Well, I'll tell you, it's Ski Jump Nose.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
Right, oh, dear.
Right, I think we're at the situation where you can't win now. Do you want the last question, or would you rather just leave
it? Give the last question.
All right, then. What would you like? Would you like... I'll give you a choice. Would you like synthesizers, or would you like personal details about your radio plugger?
Hi, job.
I'd go for that one.
Let's
go for synths, because...
Synths, all right.
I think I know which synths we used.
Right, name three synthesizers that were used on Attack of the Grey Lanterns, your world-storming number one hit album.
Right. A Mellotron, definitely.
Yep.
A Prophecy.
Yep.
And then, there was this little this roller one that we got. Oh. And it's grey.
This little roll of one that we got, and it's grey, is the correct answer! Oh, okay, so, anyway, you've not won.
No.
You've not won, but you've got three, so you've come a creditable last.
Oh, thank you very much.
Yay! All right, then.
Well done, lad.
All right, well, Chad's won the foot spa.
No.
Oh, dear, so you pass on the glad tidings, and we'll see you tonight at Manchester University.
Excellent.
All right, Andy.
Take care, mate.
Thanks a lot.
Bye-bye.
See you, bye. Wee.